Sorry, couldn't contain myself.
We will not be offering you our coffers. They are rather limited, after all. But we can give you something for your efforts. He looks towards Badger. I believe you all said that you have some proof of Justin Crow's death.
Yes, we do. I forgot. What did we grab again?
Was it his head?
I don't think it was his head. I think it was his head.
Because
you guys didn't want to take the head in case there was like influence on it.
Yeah.
Oh.
I think they almost did. Hand? But
his hand.
The hand was definitely like all whatever his name was, the anarchist, Andreev. But it might have also.
It doesn't matter. It doesn't matter too much. Yeah, you guys have something.
I have a body part of some form.
Yeah, a confirming really, body part.
I'll hand over the confirming body part.
There you go.
This is Justin Crow. Justin's Crow.
Like, yes, I'd recognize this anywhere.
Just Metal Gear.
Foreskin.
His right eyelid, of course.
Oh my god.
Fucking hell, guys. Jesus Christ.
In the Empire, we gave bounties out for such criminal activity. I believe we should carry always a practice, Captain Lois. Don't try to be so narcissistic to think that the Empire is the only place that pays our bounties, I mean. So do the Frame Realms. Alright. Let's coin you up then. Follow me. Captain Herman does take a step aside so that you guys can follow Captain Lois. Did you guys get paid off for Andreev?
No.
Not a clue.
No,
I
did not.
I don't think so.
I would lean towards
35
no.
Silver. I don't think we were, no.
No,
I don't think so.
No, the 2 gold definitely came from Badger and the extra silver starting money.
Okay, perfect. Let's I'm not gonna roll or something, I'm just gonna make it
was very sad.
Let's see, Andreev was he was an anarchist leader, but he was one of many anarchist leaders. That means that he's definitely amongst the more influential anarchist leaders, and he's also a big source of black powder. For better and worse, he's dead now.
And not only that, but we managed to convince most of his higher underlings that would probably just take his role to not. So it's not just destroying him, it's kind of destroying most of its infrastructure.
Not necessarily that piece.
Please, let it be that piece! It's more money!
Like, don't worry, Jackson tapped out, and... Not Matilda.
Myrtle
tapped out.
Old lady name.
The lower ones might still be trying for the role, but likely happen is we'll just get dogged by another leader. So the position will be filled. That's inevitability. That's just part of the game. Might not be one of his crew, but it will be filled nonetheless. Justin was definitely the higher profile target, mostly due to the entire nature of that place. Add your guys' inventory 2 gold and 50 silver.
Hey.
A gold for Andreev and a gold and a half for Justin.
2 gold, 50 silver?
50 silver, because it's 100 a piece.
50 silver. Oh, enough to do mass.
I have money now.
Congratulations.
You have a calculator for a reason, Kirsty.
What was that, sorry?
I said there's a calculator for a reason. Why would you ever want to do maths in your head?
Because otherwise I'm admitting defeat. I've been letting the dyslexia win, Nina!
Don't just calculate for
that. Don't do that. As you guys follow Captain Lois and begin giving you guys your due payouts, Captain Herman does stare at Irina, who is just sort of following you guys ever silently. But aside from that, he doesn't leave the room. He begins resuming his captain duties while he's posted up here. Hawk.
Yeah.
Didn't thou have some more private business with the captain?
Didn't think it prudent to bring it up. We kind of agreed it would happen after the fact. I don't think she needs to roll an insight to know that he's scared to talk to him.
I don't think anyone has to roll insight on that one. It's like, oh, he's trying to weasel himself out of this.
If it assages you any, Hawk. Remember, we've earned our time with him. We've fought many things, destroyed, toppled controls over our zones. You've earned his respect. Don't be afraid.
Well, as it might be one of the few times you ever can. I didn't feel like Eva was being that quiet about it.
I'll be right back. He pussyfoots a little bit before he does like the like.
Does he have any other kind of
hands there? And then
walk there again and walk back a little bit more.
He plays. He fiddles with his fingers for a bit, and then he goes.
sir, will you go to prom with me,
Mr. Herman?
Herr Herman.
Herman.
Yeah. So you go up to the captain, who's in the middle of poring over the nearby map or a local map, rather. You can see that there are staked different outposts, forward operating bases, observation posts, the works. It's, in a way, familiar to you, although the structuring is different, but the logic is the same.
Yeah. Any of his guardsmen around?
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
I'll stand there. He knows I'm there. I wait to be... spoken to.
He looks up from the map and gestures with... He lifts a hand off the table as they're both just sort of widely stretched and placed upon the tabletop, but he lifts one and gestures you to come closer by the table.
Take a big step forward. Now I'm at the table.
You are at the table.
Table acquired.
Sir, I was hoping to steal a moment to talk to you about that personal matter I brought up earlier.
Let us hear it.
With all due respect, sir, I would ask that this be kept. There you go, between us.
He stares at you for a moment. I see. Very well. He does turn to one of the guards and, if I'm not back within 5 minutes, hunt him down. He just slipped up. And thus the two of you take your leave out of the room into a more secluded place. I ask you, do you want this to be whispers or public?
It can be public. The last one. Secrets. The last one was public. Kirsty... And Fred had gone to bed by that point, but cops already privy.
This is discrimination against those Europeans.
USA, USA.
What Crash does is specifically puts Kirsty into whispers, and then we have a public conversation.
I'm such a dick move.
It would, wouldn't
you're
it?
Oh, Chris, you're dead. It's okay.
I mean,
it would be according to Zinch's plan.
Put her in a special chat called Zinch's plan.
I should do that. I'll do that later. Oh wait. Actually, you just reminded me of something. Hold on. I need to. How do you set the?
Oh God! What the fuck did I remind him of?
Zinch's plan, of course.
Also, it is Darklight's 13, right? I can't remember.
13th,
yeah, it's
for 13th
session. Mm-hmm. Yeah, there we go.
It does this do what I think it does? It does not. Shit.
Meld.
Is it a law?
Wait, so how does it show? Is it this? No, it's not that either. How do you do the little motto underneath your name?
Oh, like when you're in a VC specifically?
No. Like you see on the right side.
Oh,
of, like,
yeah.
The users, like you have a replication. How do you do that?
You click on your little thing at the bottom, your icon on your bottom left.
Uh huh.
And then
the
just
status.
Custom status.
Oh, okay. Interesting. I thought that was like a different thing.
You can set change, or
clear.
Sarah.
No. Very good. Very good, very good. Alright, so yeah, you take a take a bit of a walk. You go isolate yourself to, into a vulnerable location alone with Captain Herman. Very good, very good.
Yep. He's got a negative con mod, you're fine.
You're probably right hook him and take him out.
Yeah, he might have a negative con mod, but unlike you, he has multi-attack.
I don't know what you're talking about. I have two hands and two weapons.
So does he.
No! He has
three!
No, you guys go find a ward of some, like a isolation ward. He enters in, you follow behind him, close the door behind the two of you. So, what do you want to talk about?
As soon as he says that, my heels click together, my back straightens up, and I give him a very familiar salute. And all at once, talk is no more. As he says, "Sir, it is with a heartfelt apology that I say that I have deceived you."
He quirks an eyebrow. What's the alien?
Yeah, sir.
One that lies all the way out here. I human old man, this. Are you an oracle? Or an unbeater? These terms are semi-familiar to you, but they're not super familiar to you. I'll give you one of them for free. Which one do you want to know? Which one is which, I guess? That's a really weird way of saying it. Which one do you want to know about?
Do that second one, because I don't even know what you said.
Unbeater. It is... The simplification, the blunt translation, is an agent, an operative.
Ah.
As for the other one, roll me your lore.
Okay. Oh, no, that's the wrong sheet. Hey. Oh, roll 21. No guidance unless he's giving it to me.
Is that about? How is he here? So yeah. An oracle, or they have a longer name. Orden der Fernen Oracle, which is translates to Order of Distant Oracles. That is the state name, if you want to call it that, of the spies of the Empire, because they are seen as, well, deliverers of providence. No one said that the Empyrean Emperor is omnipresent, though. That's why he has the oracles to maintain that. So he's asking if you're some sort of spy or some sort of field agent or operative. Right. Oh yeah, let me tell that for you.
Oh yes, please do. Orden der Fernen. Der Fernen. Der
Fernen. Of course. Mine.
The colloquialism is just calling them oracles, though.
Mm-hmm. Right. I will, maintain my salute because you can say at ease.
He ain't giving you at ease until he finds out who you are.
Yeah. chest somewhat puffed out. He says, neither, sir. I'm not here on behalf of the Imperial Emperor.
Then who are you here for? And he does do like a hold, he holds his hand up like Baldwin in the King of Jerusalem movie, putting you at ease.
His hand goes back behind his back to rest. And he says, "For clemency, Herman."
He throws his brow at that, probably one of the more visible notes of expression you've seen from him during your entire time of having known him. Clemency. What do you mean?
Through foul circumstance and cowardice, I have been made a deserter.
What foul circumstance makes you a deserter?
I served in
Katz Company of the Western Front. Dragoon Squadron. We... A sergeant. A man by the name of Dietrich Krusp. He sought to abandon his post to make off with Imperial supplies with the intent to sell them.
Did you report this?
We did not have the chance, but it was not my intention. I feared my own comrades.
They were all traitors.
To my knowledge, to the man, no one said a word in disagreement. I think we all feared each other in a way. Of course, he feared no one. He was the mastermind.
Then how did you find yourselves out here? None of the people with you are Svalian.
Our desertion was short-lived. We were ambushed by a squad of bugbear commandos.
You said on the Western Front.
Yeah. In one of the 62nd squads.
This is not the only place where such squadrons existed. The Dragoons are shown, have been shown to be effective in other fronts.
And in any other front, they are afforded some degree of agency. They're not always overwatched by their commissar. Of course, because that's his advantage.
Why do you believe me to be your clemency? It has been a long time since I served the Empire.
Correct, and in truth, I'm not sure there's much you can do for me, but I have to try for my family. If there is any contact back to the homeland that you can point me in the direction of, I would happily report myself to them, that I might serve the Emperor, no matter how far I am from home, that I might earn my pardon in his eyes.
You do realize if you report yourself back into the Emperor's service, your service might bring you immediately to the gallows.
His face kind of scrunches up at that. Like, yeah, that did occur to me.
Maybe so. But it is my hope that the Emperor, in his ever-present wisdom, would see the use in a repentant deserter. One who was unwilling, and one who seeks to right the wrong he has committed.
The Emperor walks in enigmatic ways. He thinks for a moment. You're not quite sure if the muttering is to you or to himself.
What does he mutter?
The Emperor works in enigmatic ways.
Oh, okay.
When I first came out here, when I first took a captain's position here in Valkesta, I was approached by an arbiter. He wanted information. Not a one-time occurrence, but a steady stream of it. I declined his offer. If I were a different man, one who hadn't finished his time in service, you and I would not be having this conversation. But I at least earned my survival, his respect, one and the same. That was years ago. But I would not be surprised at all if there was an Unbeater or an Oracle somewhere. Somewhere here. In Velcastor. Or in Valtornio. I am not in a position to uncover such. For a number of different reasons. But I would inquire. Although be careful. The Unbeaters have an immense amount of agency out here in the field. They are trusted agents of the Empire, and loyal without a fault. Unfortunately, their loyalty might also result in zealotry, and they might find you guilty before you even make it back to the homeland. Even despite your unfortunate circumstances.
It is a dangerous game to play.
It is. It is a spy's game. And I am not one to engage in the world of espionage. Only reconnaissance.
Perhaps I would have been better off at the Spy Academy. But instead they put me on horseback. Not that I can complain.
Those at Helix Tail Academy are... You're better off. I mean, no offense to those graduates of the Academy, but they are rather... monofocused, for better and worse.
Right. So there's likely an Arbiter here in... Velcastor, Valtornio, either side.
If not in here, there might be nearby.
This agent that contacted you years ago, did he tell you where you might contact him if you changed your mind?
He did not.
I suppose I shouldn't be surprised.
I made it rather pointedly clear. My time with the Empire was done.
I see.
If I were you, if you're in search of such an Unbeater, he thinks for a moment. As much as I disdain the area, places of politics would be your best place. That, or large conglomerations of people. Somewhere easier for them to hide in.
Valtornio, then.
He nods, most likely.
It seems I have another reason to go north. Don't fear, Herr Herman. I will prioritize these peace talks. If not for nothing, out of fear of looking for an Arbiter.
I do not know what an Arbiter's opinion would be on our current circumstance. We are not near the Empire. The toppling of a city-state would mean nothing to them, aside from a future problem that the Oracles would have to calculate for.
If I had to hazard a guess, I would imagine an agent of the Emperor would be most amused to see the state of this place. After all, nothing like this would ever happen back in the homeland.
He shakes his head. No, it would not. But we are not in the Empire, and we are far from the Emperor's light out here.
You know what they say. And in the Free Realms, do as the Free Realms do.
I'd rather not. I've held true to myself for the most part, up until now.
It's done you good so far, Captain.
He nods. I believe we've taken enough time.
Of course.
And there should be 5 minutes around now, so we should go back before you get hunted.
Oh, right. put a hand on the door. If you don't mind me asking, which front did you fight on?
It was the western front.
I took you for a trenchman.
He chuckles the first time he heard laughter from him. I might show you yet, youngster. I might be old, but I still have my speed.
Well, maybe I'll get to see it before this war is over. But hopefully not. Open the door. But can you imagine? I'm serving alongside a goblin now.
He does not chuckle at that. He just sort of looks pained at the logic. at the happening. You do open up the door and see two honor guards and walk in the with their weapons out.
Desperate times, eh?
When the captain walked out with you, and then there's like, okay. You get out this time. We're watching you, though.
Thank you for this talk, Captain.
Make no mention of it. He salutes his guardsman who saluted him back. So you begin to return back to the war room. In the meantime, people in the war room, can you guys all do me a favor? Can you guys roll me a perception check using your charisma?
Oh no.
Oh, that was only fine.
I went from a 6 down to a 2.
That is unfortunate.
Roll good.
Yeah, just roll good, lol. Just roll the good.
L-O and L.
Wait a minute. Wait. Oh, yeah, okay.
That's pretty fucking good. D4 from guidance. I assume Karadok is helping.
You think we would know to be casting it, so.
Well, shit. Mine's only down by -1 then.
Very good. All is well in the world.
Damn it.
Oh, it's not, though.
All is well in the world. Yours are being paid your coin. Just sort of vibing. But is there anything you guys do?
Other than munch on snacks and try and grow 10 HP, I can't really think of much.
You guys are free to take a short rest, so.
Okay, I'm gonna do that then.
And you would gain a free D8. Oh, actually, wait. Be more because of I totally forgot Song of Rest. One of the least used features in the game, but that's beside the point.
We got D8. More using counter charm, from Chef.
Correct. So you get a D6. A D6 and a DA for free. As long as you use... You have to expend a hit die, though, to be able to tap into this.
Oh. Alright, please be low.
Do you want to be high, technically?
Yeah, what? Yeah, but then I don't want to end up overhealing.
I mean, it's irrelevant.
Because it's sad when you overheal. That was only a 2. Fuck, I gotta take a buff!
Well, you still have a D6 on top of it.
Yeah, so that's 4, 5, 6. I overheal by 1. That's fine.
Just double checking. Physically, I'm not here, right? Did I get taken to the...
You're taken to the Shadow Realm?
You're back now. Dog
to Detroit.
You're back now.
I'm back now.
You actually saw a semi-familiar... Well, maybe less so to you, but more so to Mina. You saw a Medic Lawrence. This is him, because you don't remember what he looks like. He was the guy that gave you guys your initial checkup when you first came here. The bottom line of your checkup that he reports is there's not much they can do to fully check you. They don't have that magical means of capability. But they can check, under Captain Loyce's instruction, the side effects of if you are or aren't. Right? So they can't necessarily check to see if you have the microbes of a sickness, but they can check to see if you have the symptoms of a sickness. And they don't necessarily care what type of sickness it is. The fact that you have it at all is the cause for concern. And a lot of it seems to be reaction checks or